And here's the official welcome now. We need to do one more technical thing. Bobby, can you turn the monitors over here down just a tad on this side? Not over here, but over here. All right, so thank y'all again for coming out tonight. I'm Scott Blake, and like you said, a lot of us went to college together, junior college, and she Yates formed us into what we are today. And we don't tell everybody that. We're saying that just because he's here tonight. Anyways, I want to introduce the group to you real quick. Back over here, we'll start with the ladies from Alexander City, Miss Alicia Helena right here. From Auburn, Jennifer Jones. From Utah, Gigi Hankins. From Alexander City, Tara Spicker. In the back there, on the far side, is Billy Timken from Alexander City. He's hiding back there in the dark. We got Mr. Greg Willis right here from Wetumpka. The NBC mine. And then, I thought that was funny. Yeah. Nah, no, they can't see the NBC, yeah. And we have Steve Lewis from right here in Sulacaca. Y'all know Steve here? All right. On the loud racket you hear up there, drummer, yeah, he's doing well up here, is Steve Kelby Culberson from Alexander City. We have Vinnie Pinkins from Wetumpka, Michael Richardson from Alexander City, and the group that holds us all together on the keyboards is Ms. Robin Lewis. And now, for your listening enjoyment and entertainment, we're going to have a song from the 1970s, and the Carpenters had this out back in 1970, I think. Merry Christmas, Darling, performed by our own Miss Alicia.
True, but I I the microphone and the band's giving away, but I heard Miss Yates lean over to Mr. Yates a little while ago and said, I have never seen so much culture in one place that was up on that stage. And we would be remiss if we didn't share some of our culture with y'all tonight. So we've got a lot of book learning at Junior College, and we want to bring some of that and share it with you. So you're going to go home tonight smarter than when you got here. If you can listen, just right here. Billy, tell them who Santa Claus' favorite elf is.
Got it. Rudolph.
Right? Rudolph. Billy, it's third year we've done this, but you ain't got it right yet. Y'all remember from last year, right? Y'all about to say it together. This group needs a lot of culture, Kevin.
They got a lot of culture.
Well, Santa's favorite elf is Elvis Presley. Elvis. Y'all remember now, don't you? Yeah, about the same grown from last year.
Just remember, you get what you pay for.
That's right. Nothing says Christmas like an old fat guy in a jumpsuit cut down to his belly button, bedazzled, sweating with sideburns. That just says Christmas to me. And in that regard, we're going to have Scott.
Yes, there he is.
The jump cruiser at the cleaners. But we bedazzled him the best we can.
I know we have sideburns, that's it.
We're going to let him sing Blue Christmas.
Let's go. Without you.
Bobby, were one of us off?
Two of us. They know who they are.
Well, I want to make sure we point them out.
You have one job, is to mute and unmute your microphone. Yeah.
Oh, we looked good.
Yeah, we looked good.
My high kicks were excellent. I've been stretching.
Let's go on.
Jesus, the Son, and the Child of God. course, it is about the birth of Christ, time with family, focusing on the love that we share, finding those common ground of why we love one another so much, and that love is fulfilled through Christ in each of us. Welcome, Jennifer Jones, as she sings Hallelujah.
Let's hold on. There's a wonderful story that I love to tell about a tiny little baby in a manger. So gather around me now and listen well about a tiny little baby in a manger. It happened oh so long ago, amid the cold of the winter snow. He came from heaven to the air below. This tiny little baby in a manger.
This tiny little baby in a manger.
And the angels say,
tragedy has happened or something, and our prayer tonight
is that when you leave here, you have felt the Christmas spirit, and you can feel the joy of Christmas. And so that's our prayer tonight. None of us get paid for all this. We just do it because we enjoy. They enjoy singing, they enjoy playing, and I enjoy telling a Christmas story. We just do it because we want to help raise money for the different houses. And also, I want to tell you that we want to thank all our sponsors. And if you can, in the back of the program, if you could look at that, you find a sponsor there. If you'll go by there and tell them what you appreciate, we would appreciate that, because we do have to have equipment that we use for this. But I love Christmas. I love driving through town. You know, my wife and I were riding around town last night looking at the different Christmas lights. I don't know, how many of y'all do that? Did anybody here do that? I love doing that. It's so much fun. And we were looking at the different lights in the yards. We were looking at the street lights here in LA City. And it's all beautiful. And we just absolutely love it. But I would like for you tonight to journey back with me to the very, very first Christmas. I'd like you to go to Bethlehem with me tonight. Just journey back in time. And it's busy. Bethlehem is busy. It's the streets are crowded. Caesar Augustus has made a decree that all people should be counted. And so it's just a busy time of year. The dogs are barking, kids are playing, street vendors are selling their goods, the store owners are setting their displays and checking their shelves. It's just busy. It's so busy that people don't notice a lowly carpenter and his wife. A lowly carpenter named Joseph and his wife named Mary and on a donkey as they're coming into town. And if you could just follow Joseph with me just a minute, you can see him. He's going into this inn. And he asks the innkeeper, "Do you have any rooms?" And the innkeeper says, "No, we don't have any rooms. It's too busy. We're all full." And he goes to another one. "Do you have any inn? Do you have any room?" He says, "No, we don't have any room. It's too busy. We're all taken up." Maybe he goes to a third one. And you can almost see the desperation in Joseph as he's looking for a place where his wife can rest. She's expecting a child just any moment. And so he tells the innkeeper, he says, "Do you have any room?" And he says, "I don't have any room." And he pleads for his wife, just like any good husband would do. She needs a place to sleep. She's expecting a child at any moment. He thinks, he said, "Well, I don't really have any place, but I do have a place. If you want to use it, you can use it." And he said, "I got a stable out back." And so he gives Joseph a few blankets, and they go out to the stable, and it stinks. It smells like dung. It smells like urine. The air is filled with the odor of sheep and goats and livestock. And then they walk into the stable, and it's dirty. It's a cold, hard, dirt floor, and you can see the mice running across. And you look up, and you see the spider webs just clinging across the ceiling, and you can see the spider as they weave their webs. There's not much straw. But Joseph gathers up the straw that he can. He just gathers it up and he makes a bed for Mary. My friends, I'll tell you something. That's the environment that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came into. It wasn't a nice, lush, plush, sterile hospital bed with well-trained doctors and nurses and all kinds of equipment. No. There weren't any parades, no dignitaries. Just Mary and Joseph. Not even the shepherds. You see, the Bible tells us that in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared. filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you this day is born in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was an angel, multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. I can just imagine the shepherds. The angel speaks. The choir sings. And they say, "Forget about the sheep. Let's go find this thing. Let's go find this baby." They tell it everything that they've been told. And Mary ponders. I've often wondered what Mary pondered. I wonder if she pondered what the angel Gabriel told her when he said, "You've been found favor with God." Maybe she pondered what the angel said about her son Jesus. "He will be mighty. He will be the Son of God." I wonder what Mary pondered. I wonder if Mary knew that every time she kissed the forehead of this baby, she was kissing God. I wonder if she understood that every time that little baby wrapped his hand around her little finger, that one day that same hand would feel the nails that would hold him to a cross for her sins and ours. I wonder, did she really understand and realize that the rags that baby was wrapped in that night would one day be exchanged for the robes of majesty and glory? Mary, did you know? Perform by Mr. Big Woods.
The dawn was me, the praises of God.
heard something that you have enjoyed tonight as we make our way back onto the stage. We've done a little bit of classics, you said, who'd you hear your song? Billy. The Eagles, yes, the Eagles. Oh, a lot of Lawrence Welk. Anybody? Lawrence Welk? Mm-hmm. Got that vibe tonight. Yeah, we've got a lot of that. And the next song we're going to do has been sung by several different artists before, Mariah Carey, but my favorite is the more Southern gospel version of the song. But it also talks about that the wise men came from a fire.
They were in one accord. What not with that?
We got jokes for days. Yeah. All right, our next song.
I'm here laughing.
Our next song is Jesus, What a Wonderful Child.
Unmute.
Anybody?
Jesus, oh, what a wonderful child.
The Christmas Carol I Heard the Bells on Christmas Day was written in 1863 by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. It tells the story of a narrator hearing Christmas bells during the American Civil War, and how the bells were declaring that peace on earth and goodwill to men. Bing Crosby originally sang the song, but then the Casting Crowns came up with a new version, and to sing that will be the one and only Stephen Lewis. Sorry, I can't see this at all.
Sweet day.
I've heard about this baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to you. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall. We'll be right back.
of Holy Communion.
You in the back row, smile. One, two, three, can y'all see us? One, two, three. Now turn around and get more of the band. Who's rocking? Oh my goodness.
There you go.
Come in, somebody's off over here. 1, 2, 3, yeah. My hair didn't look right. Hang on a second.
Mr. Yates,
she says she got it. I'm doing another one. There's one hair. If you come, you gotta come up here and get a microphone. Oh, that's why I don't need a microphone. I'm sorry. Doo-wops, and now I'm going to do some country.